Hi guys! In this tutorial I'm going to teach you how to draw this elevation of a building. For that we are going to use this floor plan, and the elevation itself is the view from this side. Now, the method I'm going to show you here consists in drawing guidelines where I need to place windows, doors and wall limits in the elevation drawing. For example, this window here, I just need to follow its guideline and then I easily know where I have to draw it. So, let's start. For drawing the guidelines, you can still use the command line, or there is also a tool which is not frequently used called construction lines. Just go to the drawing tab, click in this arrow, and you can find the command here. Click on it, and the first line I have to draw is exactly where I have to place the wall limit at the left. It's this endpoint, then draw a vertical line. I click and press escape. But before continuing, I want these construction lines in a separate layer. I just have to go to the layer properties. I have it already open here at the left. If not, you can always click in the layer icon above. To add a new layer, I click in this window with the right button of the mouse, go to new layer, type for the name, for example, guidelines, and I would change also the color to one I can easily differentiate from the drawing. For example, this red one. Now, in the workspace, the first thing I click in this line, then go to the Layers tab and put it in the Guidelines layer. To draw the remaining lines, I will use the command Offset to do this process quickly. I type O and press Enter. Offset is active. Then, in Specify Offset Distance, I type through, I press Enter, and with this option I select the line, and then I'm going to place the new parallel line in the point I click, for example here. Then I keep drawing lines in all the places I have windows and doors. I select the previous line, but this time instead of clicking right now, I type M for multiple, press Enter, and now I can click in all the places that I want. Let's go forward. I need one in this wall, then in the door, and I'm going to fast forward until the end. I think it will be easier for you to do this. I finish everything, and as I zoom out, you can see that the construction lines continue infinitely. Ah, and there is also this door that I forgot to draw previously. Now I can start drawing the elevation. And the first thing that we will do is drawing this line that indicates the ground floor. I'm going to use the command line to draw a horizontal line here to cover all the floor plan. After, I'm going to use the command trim. I press enter. I select the horizontal line and all the guidelines. Press enter again. And I'm going to delete the sections out of the floor plan. Here this section, and also this one at the beginning. Press enter. Now, I am going to draw the elevation of these walls using the dimension lines I have here. And I start with this one, 2.4 meters. It's very simple. With the command line, I go to this endpoint, click on it, and draw a vertical line with length 2.4. Then, just press Escape to continue drawing. This time, I draw these lines with the lengths that you can see there. So, just have to find the proper guideline, this one, and draw all the lines with its lengths. The first is 0.9, then 1.8, 1.8 again, and the last 1.5. Next thing, I draw this line, which is the right extremity of this front wall. But I have to change this dimension line to measure just from this line until the roof. And then the height of the wall will be the combination of these lengths. Going back to the drawing, the guideline that we need is this one. So I will have to follow it, and here I will draw the wall. I activate the command line and draw four vertical lines with the distances I showed you before. 0.9, 2.8, 2.8, and finally 0.2. Then I have to draw the lines at the top. I'm going to start with this one, and then I can draw the both remaining ones. It's simple. So, here you have. Then I just draw a vertical line downwards and just connect with the one at the right I have drawn before. Finally, just click in this line, then at this extremity at the bottom and connect to the intersection. So now the other lines that makes the outline of the walls, these ones, you can draw easily by yourself just using the dimension lines. So, after this, I can start drawing the elevation of the roof, and I'm going to start with this small detail in the right part of the building. Simple, you just have to follow these dimensions of these lines. I'm going to activate the command line, go to this endpoint, and make the line of 0.08 meters. Then another of 0.02, and this vertical one of 0.03 meters of length. As you may notice, I'm drawing these lines using the grid and the snap mode. After, I have to draw this arc of radius 0.02. I'm going to click in the icon arc, but in this arrow below. Here I choose the way I want to draw the arc. For example, I want to enter the start point, first the center, and finally the end point. Also, if you look to the arrow here, you can see the direction of drawing is anti-clockwise. I click here for the start point, then the center, and finally end point. Then these remaining lines you can draw by yourself. Now I want to copy these lines to the other side of the roof. For that, I'm going to use the command mirror, select the lines I drawn this time, press enter, then click in the endpoint of this horizontal line to draw a vertical mirror line so I can copy symmetrically the objects to the other side. I click and then choose No to keep the original objects. Here they are. Now I can proceed to draw the roof. Oh, I forgot to draw this line, but it's okay, I can draw it just now. type L for activating the command line, and draw it here. Now, to draw the roof section, I know that it makes an angle of 30 degrees with the x-axis. So, I'm going to use the command line, go to the endpoint here, and I'm going to draw a line until more than the half. I press tab to switch to the angle setting, and I will type 150 degrees in order to have the angle here 30. I press enter and escape. Then I do the same on the other extremity. Type L to activate line. But first, draw this vertical line that I forgot before, F0.12. And then I continue. Press tab to switch to the angle. And this time I have to type 30. Now I press escape. And okay, I have to extend the line. For example, clicking in it, go to this extremity, click and extend it. Be sure this label extension is here. Now I can click. I press escape and I can use the command trim to delete the parts that I don't need. Select everything, press enter, click in this section and then here. So the first outline is completed. Then, to draw the second diagonal line, I will need to draw first this part, which the length of these three lines is 0.08 meters. Then I can use, for example, the command offset. I type O, press enter. In specify offset distance, I choose through. Now I select the line and I'm going to click in this endpoint here. Okay, so just need to press escape. I can use the command trim, for example. Select this part, press enter and delete the line. On the left side, I could use mirror to copy the lines that I didn't draw, or I can still draw them fast. As I'm using the grid and snap mode, I can draw them quite simply. Then the diagonal line, another option is to select it, click in the endpoint and extend it until this intersection. Now the elevation of this roof is finished. So it's everything in this first part of this tutorial to draw an elevation. Subscribe to CAD in Black if you haven't done it yet. And if you need online private lessons, just send me an email to cadinblack@gmail.com so I can give you more details. Thank you and till next time.